Hey everyone, it's Luron here and welcome back to my channel. Guys, in today's video I want to talk about Netflix. Now, Netflix is reporting earnings next week. That will be actually this week, Thursday the 19th of January. And I'm expecting a big move for this stock simply because this one has been sold off tremendously back in 2022. And I believe there is a great case for this one to move higher. Now, I'm looking at a lot of analysts rating on this one, and I'm seeing a lot of bullish signs. As you can see here, a lot of upgrades by Jefferies. You know, they're calling for about 400, Wells Fargo, 400, Pivotal Research Group, 375. And as you all know, Netflix is, it's a solid company. I mean, lately it has, you know, declined significantly as the overall market has, you know, in the past year. Now, if you look at the bottom line and top line for this stock is continually, you know, generating more and more sales or revenue, and their bottom line is continually increasing. If you look at 2017, 2021, this thing is stair-stepping. And that's one of the characteristics I like to look for when trading these high flyers. And Netflix is no stranger to being a high-flying stock. Very volatile, moves well. And I expect a huge move in the upcoming earnings on the 19th. Now, this one, if you look at the charts here, you can see we made some massive move lower. If you look at back in January, we had a massive 22% move. If you look at the next earnings that we had back in April, we also made a big move, 35%. Now, this thing bottomed here, you know, in May 2022. And as you can see here, we started to make higher highs and higher lows. You look at all these higher highs and higher lows, and we're making tons of heads and shoulders as we go higher, which is a great characteristic of this stock looking to, you know, maintain the momentum. We did fill this gap here last week, which is good. Sometimes we can have a gap fill reversal, which is what I'm expecting. So within this week, this upcoming week, you know, the 16th, we have a holiday. You know, the week of the 17th there, leading into earnings, I expect Netflix to pull back to about 310 area, 310, 305 area. Now, in that pullback, that will be the completion of the full head and shoulder, the next head and shoulder that we're seeing setting up here. Once you have that pullback, the day of the earnings, we can have a move taking us to about 380, 400, which is this next level that we have here. You see 400, that's the next key level for the stock to move higher. Now, it could move lower too, right? Let's say they reported some poor earnings. This stock could decline. We can pull back to about, you know, 278 or 260 level. Now, going into earnings, what I usually do, I usually straddle these stocks. I mean, I don't put too much creed into determine exactly what the stock will do. So for earnings, predominantly earnings, I straddle stocks. So when I say straddle, I mean I buy and I trade options. So I'm not trading stocks. If you're trading stocks, then straddling this doesn't make sense, right? I mean, you'll just be net zero. You won't make any money. So if you're trading options, you can straddle these companies and make great money when you expect a big move on earnings. Now, if you don't expect a big move on earnings, you certainly don't want to straddle because the premiums will just, you know, lose all their value, and you have theta decay after earnings, and you won't make any money. But I expect a big move. I expect a pullback here within this week, and on earnings, I expect a big jump. So my straddle, I'll buy some call options for about 360, and I'll have some for 380. That expires the 20th of January. So weekly options I'm talking about. Again, I'm buying 360, 380 calls. And the protection on the bottom, the puts, I'm looking to get some puts right at this support level here at 250 puts. My ratio on these straddle would be, I'm looking for about 80% long, because that's my bias, and I'll have 20% of my capital for put options because I want to protect myself. So let's say it doesn't go higher, which is my bias, and it goes lower, I usually cover, I'll cover my full premium on the top side as well, maybe some profits, but that won't be my expectation. We'll just be expecting to cover the premium for the call side. But if it goes higher, I expect to make about 10 to 12x on my money. So if I invest $100, you expect to make $1,200, $1,000, you expect to make $12,000. That's the play that I'm expecting on Netflix this coming week. So that's a quick video I wanted to do to show you guys what's my trading plan for this week. Now, if the week starts and this one started to move higher into the earnings, now it blows up my entire plan, and I wouldn't be trading this one into the earnings because the explosive move that I would expect wouldn't take place anymore. Or even if it does, it will be outside of what I consider my edge in this strategy that I have. So this is one of my edges. And like I said, if it break the mold of my edge, then I just walk away and I don't trade it for the earnings. But if it pulls back, which I expect it to do, then I'll be straddling this one. So that's my analysis for Netflix. Hopefully you guys, if you have some, you wanna be in the game, you can see my analysis, make your own decision. This is not, you know, investment advice, but I'm showing you guys exactly what I do to make money consistently in the stock market. So until next time, we'll talk later, guys. Have a good one.